What's up, everybody? This is day 175, Make It Songbringer. And today, I have the new overworld procedural world generator working and displaying this nice debug output. This is pretty cool because I can work on the overall algorithm for how it creates this new style maze. And see what shapes it's making. And then I can go and kind of compare it to shapes that I know I find interesting to play as a gamer. And then, yeah, make it smarter. What's up? Alex Pita. I'm doing good, man. How are you doing? So yeah, today's goal basically is to take that. So I've got this new quad maze going. And by the way, this game, Songbringer, is a Windows, Mac, Linux game coming out on Steam. And it's also going to come out on like this cool retro game system called Retro VGS. So yeah, so this is like The Legend of Zelda, but procedurally generated. So I'm working on this. I got this new procedural world generator. Now I'm going to turn this into an actual overworld area based on that new maze. So one thing I did when I created this was I hooked up a cool setting so I can turn that off and on really quick. Nice. Cool. Relaxing. Enjoying your stream. So yesterday we established that Mars of Power is a time traveler and he actually travels time in reverse, which is sweet, right? All right, so did that map? Here we go. Okay, so this screen, yeah, to the left. Okay, I gotta keep working on these screens now. That's what the goal of this is to, okay, so this area that the player appears in here, the very first area, I want it to mimic that maze. So from memory, that maze, well, we could just actually switch to that window now. Yeah, so this maze has part of the screen there is cut off so that you can't move on it. So I'm gonna make it like that. And then the edges to move off the screen are on the tops. So that's the goal. To basically take this part right here, move it up a bit, and this opening over here, move it up a little bit to match the maze is output. He's a wine traveler. Mars of Power. Okay, so in area patterns is where I'm going to be working here. And I've already got this somewhat established. I think I took it out of pattern quadrant. Okay, so I want to take it out of pattern home as well. I believe pattern home has its own custom patterning. Yeah, so turn off this X center, Y center stuff. That should fill that in with rocks or bushes. Yeah, there we go. Cool. Okay, so this is what this is what it's going to look like. But now I'm going to go and carve paths into the sub quadrants of the scene based on this. There he is. Welcome back. Welcome back, dude. Welcome back to the present time. Okay, so after we run pattern home, we add water, and then we place the openings, or no, wait. Yeah, place openings, that should be called. Place openings. Whatever, pattern openings, who cares? Hey, wine travelers. Wine traveler. Pattern openings, give it the current maze it's gonna work with. Cool, we've already got that maze. All right, so we'll do a loop over the maze, sort of like the overworld's loop. Yeah, I did, check it out. Here's the new maze generator algorithm. This is sort of a first, this is the first version one of it, you know? I think there's gonna be maybe two or three more versions. Cause it's, It's almost a little bit too machine-like right now. I want to make it a little more human. Cause you see, like from this overworld, yeah, I mean it's entirely full. There's a little bit too much of it if it is full, right? Cause when I compare it to the Zelda overworld map. See, it's kind of distinct. It's kind of human. It's very, like, designed, this world. So, yeah. Now we'll do this pattern openings. Here, like this, for maze and for compass stir. Okay, so this loops over all the maze directions. Man, time traveler. Time traveling. Drinking your wine. You got this like flask of wine. You got one of those Boda bags. You got a Boda bag of wine. A wine skin. Wine skin traveler. So do we need the offset for this? Maybe not. All right, this is area pause dot X, area pause dot Y, quadrant direction. Yeah, this sounds cool. Genetic algorithms. It's a flask. Oh, it's a flask. What the heck is that? What'd you call it? Genetic algorithms? A search heuristic that mimics the process of natural selection. Huh. And what? 11 evolutionary programming? Huh. Oh, Survivor Selector. Ah. Right, so we got this pattern openings, which is going to create openings in the area. We're looping over the quadrant, so each area is divided up into four different quadrants. And each quadrant also has four different compass directions, which are north, south, east, west. And we're gonna go and check if there is a wall, then we're not gonna create an opening. Otherwise, we're gonna create an opening like path type area. So we're gonna loop over some X, some Y, and yeah. I see. All right, Y is less than. All right, so we're gonna go a quarter of the width and a quarter, maybe like an eighth of the height. No, just 3, 3. Yeah, 3, 3. Like the width or the height of the path we're gonna carve is gonna be about 3 tiles, and the width of the path we carve is also gonna be about 3 tiles. So let's do y equals -1. Y is less than 1. No, less than or equal to 1. Y plus plus. Right. Score them all and then sort them by that score, and then maybe add a little random choice to choose a do a new a different one. So we'll loop over the X similar. And just set the tile. So we need like a starting X. Let's just do this. This is going to depend on the compass direction. And the quadrant. So each quadrant is going to have an offset. Yeah. But this is fantamazing. What's up, Baz and Riz? Happy today. So the quadrant to southwest is going to have, yeah, the offset's going to be width times a quarter. Yo, Lighter Thief, what's up? What's up? All right, so then we're just gonna set offset dot x equals floor f offset dot x. So right, if offset is, yeah, floor f, we wanna use floor f here. Yellow, orange, red. What is Mars the cookie today? What you got, what are you concocting? What do you got in your flask? Popcorns? Popcorn? Oh man, I kind of wish I had popcorn. I could make that. What's up, Betaville? For you guys that just joined the stream, let me show you what we're doing here. Oh, nothing. What did I break? Oh. Nice. Prepping the yeast. Yeah, so for you guys that just joined, here's what we're talking about today. So this is a pattern or an algorithm that generated this world based on the world seed random. This is not as natural as I want it to be, but anyways, I'm gonna work on this algorithm later, but right now what I want to work on is actually the code to fill in the overworld based on like the actual tiles of the game based on that overall maze you just saw. So I'm carving out new areas. So this is going to be cool because you'll be able to exit a screen either at the center, somewhere on the top, somewhere on the bottom. You know, if you're going north, you'll be able to exit going maybe in the center, maybe to the left, maybe to the right, maybe both of them. There's like a big opening. It'll create a much more interesting overworld. Momir, what's up? Right, so creating an opening at we'll do offset dot x, no y. Minus one. No, this is easier. All right, we're turning off that tile. No, yeah, good question, Adavel. No, this is not Meta Zelda. This is a totally different kind of style pattern. So yesterday's stream, I talked about it a lot, but here's what I was doing yesterday. This is the Legend of Zelda. Let's get you a better screenshot of that. This is the Legend of Zelda, right? And I had this idea to create a maze generator algorithm that works on every sub area. So like this area right here, for example, has eight different choices of where it can go on the edges. So you got like the ones to the east, you got two to the north, you got two to the west, and two to the south. And then on every screen, you also have four different areas that you can cover where that are like open ground inside that area. And they have their own south, north, south, you know, like all every one of these has east, west, north, south. They all have their own quadrants of directions that they can move on that screen. So you basically create that, like, you have 16 different choices on each area. And that creates so much more interesting overworlds mazes when you do it this way. So my goal yesterday was to create an algorithm that would create a maze using Songbringer's random number generator system with the, you know, the world seed and all that, and then create an actual screen where I can view that in the game. So I'm actually running the game here, and it's showing this overworld pattern to us live. Oh, I gotta turn it on. Overworld scene. So yeah, this is what Songbringer generated, right, for its overworld, for this particular overworld with the world seed random. So yeah, my goal now is just to fill in the actual tiles for each tiny area in the on this screen. Each one of these tiny areas will have all this stuff in it, and so I'm just trying to use it. Yeah. What's up, Arcane? All right, so yeah, I'm gonna turn off the overworld scene now we've done that. And start building these pattern openings to create more openings on the edges of each screen here. Yeah, there were some pretty long dead ends, right? But also Zelda does have a few of those. Wait. There's Zelda. Here's a dead end up in the top left. Yeah, I guess there are more. It's a good point, right? This generator has more longish dead ends. Here's a really nice long dead end. Here's a dead end. It's really long. But dead ends are kind of cool. Because at the every dead end, you've got a good opportunity for a level entrance. But I guess you don't really want to always make that so obvious. I don't know. See, here's a level entrance in Zelda. Here's another level entrance in Zelda. Or no, wait, there's two here. I don't know, are there three level entrances right here? There's one here. One here. Yeah. So, yeah, I need to work on the algorithm, right? I need to make this algorithm better. This needs to be more, yeah, interesting, natural. And what's most important is that it plays well. So, you know, I'll try it out and stuff and make sure it plays well. But anyways, besides working on that algorithm right now, I'm just actually going to do the pattern openings to make that, to create those paths within an area. Yes, Arcane, yes, that's world random. The word is actually random, RANDOM, those six letters. Right? Yeah, Momir, that's a good point. Yeah, dead ends should be a reward. Or have a reward along the way, maybe just before the dead end or something like that. No, the maze doesn't have any unreachable subpaths right now, but I did try a couple experiments with the algorithm last night and ended up with a few worlds where I was like, oh, there's this one's not, this one doesn't, you know, you can't actually reach all the subpaths. So, and it was obvious, it was pretty easily. Oh, you saw one on it? There shouldn't be. What's up, Lathune? I guess that is right there, this tiny little bit. And this is too. Oh, yeah. There are some unreachable paths on this one. Yeah, but I'll figure that out. This algorithm will get so much better than it is right now. This is only one day, you know, 2 or 3 days from now. This is going to be sick. It's going to be sick. Yes, Arcane. Yeah, those squares in the background, the purple squares are areas of the game. Like here is the screen. This is the home screen right here. This is the where the player starts. This bright square right here, and you can see it has all eight different choices for its exits. You know, every single one of these little areas has actually 16 different choices for what kind of paths are open. So now I'm going and writing the code to actually open up those paths. Yeah. Yeah, Marza, the maze kind of is a tree. The algorithm kind of is a tree algorithm right now, the way it works. Not in the data structure sense of a tree, but an actual leafing recursive kind of algorithm. Yeah, everything's going great, Lathune, for sure. Oh, Lighter Thief, that's actually a good point, right? I guess the algorithm could actually leave certain areas purposely open or purposely closed off from the rest of the maze so you could use a teleporter to get there. That would be sweet. That would create kind of like a sub part of the world that really is tricky to find. Oh, I love that idea. Oh, yeah. I'm writing that down. Purposefully. I'm such a good speller. Purposefully, fully. I wrote it phonetically. Leave some of the maze closed off and use a teleporter to get there and put something really awesome and important there. Such a good idea. You like old-fashioned, non-rewarding dead ends? Yeah, you know, right? Yeah, Adavel, good point. It definitely should have a chance to have nothing and a dead end. In fact, what has to happen in the maze generator for that to happen is there to be enough dead ends that you can fill in all the level entrances and put lots of cool rewards and stuff and still have some dead ends left over. So I guess you would also, that the bigger the world, the more of those you're going to get. Oh, Lathon. Lathon. Oh, all right. Lathon. Can I just call you Lith? Or maybe you could dig into those areas. That's cool. What's up, Tefen? Yo. So we were just discussing this algorithm right here, that this is Songbringer's algorithm version 1.0, creating a maze. And now going and I'm filling in the code for doing that. I keep on going and explaining the algorithm over and over. Lith, all right, Lith it is. So yeah, we're gonna fill in from offset.x plus x. Okay, and now we need start x and start y for this sub area. All right. I'm gonna make this actually an integer. Offset x, offset y. Oh, wait. Let's just get, yeah, let's initialize these outside. Yeah, Alex Pita, for sure. That's right, it is. Let me see if I got, let's see, settings, or we'll see, no. Let's try run without building. Oh, I hope this works. Oh, wow. I broke something. Ah, I wish I could show you the game right now. I got to finish this code before I can, though. I don't have a build still. So, all right, we've got an offset. We also need the start x, start y for each one of these runs of, these are gonna be blank tiles, basically. We're cutting a path through rocks, we're cutting a path through bushes. That's what we're doing. So we're like switch the direction, and each direction is gonna have its own unique start x, start y. Yeah, Lighter Thief, that's exactly what I'm doing right now. I'm actually writing the code. So yeah, it will all work with the same art. It should. It's just I'm changing the tiles. Really, all I'm doing here is changing the tiles that it's using. And the way mountains are shaped, it's shaped on as much rocks as it has around it. So it's a pretty flexible algorithm. So it should naturally show a totally different system like this. Yeah, it does return float. But I'm casting it to an integer here. Kdir north, right? Oh, is it D? Oh, it's compassdir. Start X is going to be this is going to be a quarter of the width. Maybe an eighth of the width. I think an eighth of the width, actually. Yeah. Right, so we got north, south, east, west. We got default break, get rid of that warning. Now just set them all up. Nice, you got some music going? Sweet. Yeah, anybody who's, look, if you want music, play your own music, please. It'd be so cool. I wish I could play music, but YouTube. YouTube! So when we're going south, we're going to start at let's get a quadrant width actually before all this. Q quadrant width is oh, well that is that does that work? I don't know if that does. There's 21. Yeah, each one of these quadrant widths would be a quarter, extra quarter. Right, Marza. See you, man. Later, Marza. Yeah. Nice, you too, man. Yeah, so I can just make this a float. That's fine. Float quadrant width is the width of this area over, times a quarter. Multiplication always faster than division. Height. Yeah, quadrant height, quadrant width. Okay. What? The heck happened? All right, so the offset. Let's think of this more in quadrants. Southwest. And yeah. So this math here was more better for suited for sprites. This is more of a tiles kind of system. Tiles are totally different. So we're gonna start with southwest at 0, 0. That's simpler anyways. And then northwest is 0. Quadrant width. Oh, and quadrant width, of course, is half. Yeah. Right. For starting at the very bottom. Cool. Okay. And then if we're, oh, this is quadrant height. Yeah. This is just quadrant width, quadrant height for northeast. And then east is quadrant width 0. Cool. Now we got a integer offset going based on floor f. So we can use floating point at first to get some accurate tile coverage. Okay, so when we start, we choose the direction. The direction north is going to be quadrant width times a half. And we'll do start and finish. Yeah, so it finishes off at Deer North. Okay. Is that right? No, this one's quadrant height times a half. Okay, so we're starting off at negative QW times a quarter. and ending off at QW times a quarter, and then ending it at the quad's height. Like that better. Right? I think I'm making it a little too complex here. Okay, let's do these other directions. We got south, which is, yeah, we're gonna go negative quad width times a quarter, positive quad, yeah. So that's what we'll do for vertical lines, basically. And then south is gonna start at 0. And finish at quad I times a half. All right, so east is going to start at a half and go to the width, and it's going to start at 'Quad width times a quarter. Yeah, I liked it better this other way. Yo, Teek, what's up? Last 2 days I've been working on this new maze generator. This is version one of this new maze generator. Generated this pattern for creating an overworld. This little tile right here is the start point. So yeah, I'm working on the code that actually carves out the overworld and actually creates these tiles. So I'm getting close to being able to show this. Set tile, Tile none. So we don't even need start and finish, we just need center. I guess that would be start and finish. No, yeah, this is the same overworld. Yeah, same overworld size. It's just that it has twice as many paths that it can go on. So it'll create a much more interesting overworld. So I want to start. Wait. Keep rewriting this. Yeah. So anyways, when you're going north, you want the X. To just be -1. And the X finish up to be 1. And that's quadrant width times a half minus 1. This is quadrant width times a half plus 1. Right, okay. South is the same X, but its Y starts at 0 and goes to quadrant height times a half. Right. Yep, and I do want to use a start X, start Y. So I want to see this converted into integers. Because tiles are integers, basically. But I do want to keep this using floating point math to keep some of the accuracy, and then convert once we're done with the math. So start x equals floref start dot x. Did I just type t both times? Finish. Man, how many times did I rewrite all this? Maybe I'm stalling. Right? Finish X, X plus plus. All right, we got, yeah. Cool, much better, much better. Yeah. Okay, so now east and west. Let's do east first. This is going to start its x at quadrant width times a half. Its y at quadrant height times a half minus one. And then similar ending ends at quadrant height plus one. Almost the same thing for west, except that you start with zero and go to quadrant width times a half. There, I think we have it. I know, right? That was one of those moments. Couldn't decide what was better. Just kept rewriting it. Okay, well, yeah. That's basically all we need, right? I'll set that x plus this whole XY madness. Let's see what the heck happens. I hope this works. What happened? Invalid area. What? Let's set a breakpoint. Not trying to do the overworld scene now. What the heck's going on here? Let's start with this, turning this tile off. I'm thirsty. Did you work? Do you still work? Still crashing? Oh, we're just breaking. All right, cool. That's definitely what's breaking it. That set tile call right there. Invalid area. I guess this could be because the X and Y. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Turn on breakpoints. I do need to see that those variables. I could have made those like way too big. So we're going from offset x. Oh, we've got offset x. That should be like that. That should be like that. Anyways, offset dot x was 0, y 10, and then x is 4, or x is 0, y is 4. Oh, I see what it's doing. It's calling invalid area a bunch of times. Messed it up that bad somehow. Yeah. It's like, oh, it's trying to create the same world over and over and over and over and over and over and over. And it keeps on returning invalid area for each area. So obviously using this function, is messing it up for the home screen only, right? Should only be the home screen is calling this. And that creates the invalid area warning. Why isn't it breaking? Let's try one of these exception breakpoints. Only a C++ exception. Break on throw. Should do it. And then this, we can disable that breakpoint. What's up, Felix? Welcome to the code. Welcome to the code. I'm almost about to get this running again. I know how to fix it. If I just comment that out, I can show you the game, but let's see if this works. What? No, you can't. Oh. That didn't work. Yeah, you can't do an all C++ breakpoint with Cocos 2DX. So I just gotta figure this out. Anyways, I'll comment this line so you can see what's going on. I got this this new maze generator algorithm. And I'm working on the home screen, which is right here, right there in the middle, this brighter screen. And I want to take the screen and mimic those white lines. So the white lines are openings. So there should be an opening on this screen up here to the top left. There should be an opening to the top right. And then what? One opening to the right here. Oh, Asmerus, yeah, I do. Yeah, I do want it to hit that finish Y and finish X. That's a good question. I guess we could start with doing just a single slice, a single area. So if they're both zero, we'll continue this loop. And then let's comment out all these directions other than, okay, so let's pick a direction. We don't want to do, let's say we want to do just that west direction. We'll carve out that. Start goes from zero on the X to half the quadrant width. Finish goes from half the quadrant height minus one to half the quadrant height plus one. Use floor F for all of that. So yeah, this, I guess this could be. I guess I should set the breakpoint again. Okay, let's do this. I gotta get a drink of water. I'm so thirsty. Okay, so what area is this? Let's make sure we're at the area that we're thinking of, right? This should be 700. So area pause 700. Good. All right, so we're in the right area. The offset X for what quadrant is this? This is the northwest quadrant. Is that right? It should be what we were wanting, right? Northwest. Yeah, that's the northwest quadrant. And what direction is west? Perfect. That's exactly what we wanted. We want the northwest west section. So what that gave us was a start X of 0, a finish X of 5. Yeah, that's about right. And a start Y of 4, finish Y of 6. Ah, cool. So Y did come out right. Quadrant width 10.5. Quadrant height 10. Okay, I'm gonna allow that one. What the heck is calling invalid area anyway? Oh yeah. This assertion when we get a tile ref. Oh. I can do this kind of manual breakpoint here. Just figure out why the heck is it crashing? Why is it, I mean, it's not actually crashing. It's just throwing an assertion. For some reason, it's not catching it right now. Good. Here we go. We got a breakpoint. We caught it. What's the problem? Offset 0, Y 10, X is. Zero, Y is 4. Duh. All of a sudden it works now? What? And it succeeds on the first try? I don't get it. Okay, I guess that something in that was broken. All right, so we do need to go farther. We need the east to be able to do that. So let's try east. Quadrant width times 1/2. Quadrant width. Quadrant height times 1/2 minus 1. Quadrant height times 1/2 plus 1. That should work. Come on, no whammies. No whammies. All right. Oh, but it just went across the whole screen. Oh, because yeah, that's part of the design for this level, is for that to go across. So we need to manually turn some of this off. Right? Well, let's see. Okay, there's south. Zero. No, yeah, it should start at zero. Let's try that, though. Let's turn off south. Looks like it carved off a couple rocks there on the right. And so north. North is the width minus one, half the width minus one. Finishes half the width plus one. Quadrant height times a half, quadrant height. I don't see any problem with that. Let's do this. Let's put a safeguard in here. It might be just like one tile too many. And then that one tile too many to the south, for example. So if x is greater than or equal to 0, and x less than or equal to... Yeah, north is the one that's doing it. Yeah. But I'm thinking if I had this little safety barrier here, this will help. If this fixes it, then I know it was just going out of bounds, basically, for one level. So this needs to be x is less than width. Oh. Let me do this. If x is less than 0, x is greater than or equal to width. Y is less than 0, y is less than or greater than or equal to height. Then we'll know that the reason it was failing to create the area is because it was out of bounds on this little slicer. Oh, look at this. See? Yeah, I don't know why it's not actually stopping there. I thought I already had a try catch in place for this. Let's put another try in. We need north. You can catch it like this, man. This is a tough tiger to catch, right? He's quick. He's ruthless. Oh, now it breaks on the get tile ref. Why, yada. All right. So what's the problem? Get tile ref X 14 Y 0. That should be fine. The only problem is the area is null. So where did it grab that area from? It grabbed it from this get area for X Y. Oh, X. That should be fine. The area. What? Okay. Let's do get area. Just set a breakpoint here. Come on. All right, there we go. Why? Why does this world not have area 14? Oh, world P 710. So yeah, it must be getting the tile ref for one. I guess the area just hasn't been created yet. Oh. Okay, so yes, this Y should be one too many. Finish, where are we at? Y itself is 10. Offset Y is 10. Okay. Wow, that took a long time to figure out. But basically, all I've got to do is go QH minus one. Turn off the breakpoints. Should work this time. Invalid area should not. Shouldn't throw like that. Whoa. Okay, anyways, we're focusing on this, making this area. Yeah, look at that. It did it. It totally did it. But the only thing is we want the home screen to be a little different. So let's make the home screen. Nice wallpaper. Yeah, thanks, man. Let's get me inspired. Yes. Oh, it worked. Yes. Yay. I'm not gonna mess with this code right now. I just want to go play with other areas and get them to use this too, especially pattern connector. Pattern connector needs to have its edges also cut out. Cut it all out. This pattern openings. Do we have the maze? We can get the maze. Get maze. There. I know, right? I should go to God mode for this. Unless I have to, I'd have to compile that. No, I think that's a setting. I haven't used God mode in a second, so I'm kind of nervous if it'll even work. Looks like it works. Whoa, that's an interesting pattern this created. Oh, here we got an exit right here. And here we got an exit there and there. This is definitely more interesting. I mean, the paths can be a little more natural, right? Like I could add a little bit of a sine wave to this right here. That'd make that more interesting. Yes, this is so much cooler. Now, if the maze was proper, right, it would be able to distinguish if there's an area that cannot be walked across, like here in the middle. So I've got to work on that next. Make it so basically these screens kind of can fill themselves in with more material. So like right now we got this little rock here in the middle, but with the old algorithm that really hadn't connected those rocks to these rocks down here. So we would need to do that. We need to actually fill in material if an exit area was closed. Interesting. So it's not connecting this edge, right? Of course, because I haven't done the algorithm yet for that. Well, let's do the algorithm for that. So what area is this? Yeah, right? A good call going to God mode. That really saves some time, right? Cool. Okay, so 850, that's where we want to go. And let's make the pattern for the level entrance or for the entrance. Actually, it's just entrance. Do-do-do-do-do, add all this. Do all this stuff. And then at the end go this pattern openings world get maze. You know what? This is getting annoying having to pass that in every time. And I don't need to do that. So screw that. Waving squirrel. Ha! Was he doing that? Okay, so in the actual function, just grabbing the maze. I love convenient methods to call, you know? If you can find a way to make things easier on yourself as a programmer, that's a great thing. You know what I mean? Less typing is a good thing. Okay. So, we want to do one more thing in the pattern entrance, and that is to turn off the center X, center Y. It's about 23 seconds or so to compile that. I measured it the other day. I was trying to improve it. And I did. I improved the build time by 5 seconds. All right, cool. Yay, now it matches up. Whoa, God mode. God mode. Forgot about this. Oh, interesting. God mode carved out these pillars. We want to actually carve out... Actually, pattern openings could be a little smarter about what types of tiles it uses for it. So we can go. You know, this would be cool too. So if offset, right? If offset plus X or I don't want to do this right now. Too much code. If this is tile. Oh, we might as well do offset X. Oh, you know what? Let's make it even more simple. Offset X plus offset Y plus. In fact, the offset can stay as a vector. We shouldn't even need this. Oh. There. Now we can easily do these tiles. X, Y. All right. K tile. If it's a bush, we're going to have to clear that out. Actually, let's get the tile. Bush, water, trees, rocks, all of these should be erased. But things like statues, platformy walking areas, things like that, those shouldn't be erased. Right there. So what this algorithm did is it didn't erase. Oh, why did it erase? Dang it. Oh, wait a minute. I could just make this a light pillar. Oh, yeah, I could take this tile and simplify it. What I'm trying to do is fix these lights right here. There's this ghost floating flame here. Pretty sure I don't need that. When it goes and creates pattern entrance, he needs to use light pillar tiles. So all the lights need to be a little lower. That should fix that. Visible wizard. I was invisible for a sec. Good night, light of thief. Good night, man. Right, what do we got? An error? What? An error? Extraneous parentheses. Nightlight time. Nightlight, night bright. Yay, there. Okay, so there. It's not ever going to erase a light pillar. We got, what do we got? You know what? So this is looking way more interesting, right? Already, this is a more interesting overworld to play. You know what I mean? This is sweet. God mode has no enemies, of course, so I'm running around. Why does God mode have no enemies? No foes is the no foes, so God mode should have foes. You should be able to turn on invincibility as well as God mode. It's looking awesome, right? This is encouraging. There. So yeah, God mode and no foes are now their own separate little settings. Is one does not imply the other. So I can run around and there's still enemies. I can still get hit by them too, even though I'm in God mode and I can run through walls. I can still be hit by enemies, which is kind of funny. But if I had invincibility on. Oh, look. Refill tile needs to use this too. Okay, so what is this? Refills 10 to 0. And let's go to the refill algorithm. It's a really easy one. In fact, it doesn't really matter which way we do that, but this pattern openings, bam! Oh, it's God mode. Yeah, Momir. So Momir, I enter some settings, right? I got all these settings. These are great for debugging, right? So one of them is God mode, and that makes me run really fast and will go through walls. So it makes it really easy to go get a feeling for the overworld really fast. And then, there's of course skip menu, which I leave on all the time pretty much. Invincible is cool for like making, debug, like just basically when you want to focus and you don't want the enemies to hit you all the time, you can turn on invincible mode. And then there's no foes, you can just turn off foes entirely sometimes. So these are all, yeah, these are all really great cheats, basically. Right, refill tile. We should have openings now. All right, cool. Yeah, so you get the opening from the bottom here. Ooh. Getting close. Oh, I fell off the world. Oh no. God mode, you can walk off the edge of the world. Hey, so what was that? What's that game called? Wheels over the road. Or is it just over the road racing? Big rigs over the road racing. Oh my God, if you guys haven't seen this. This is so funny. Angry Video Game Nerds is the best video. Look at this, you can just drive right through trees. You can drive through anything. There's no water. Right? This game actually came in a box. Right, you paid like I don't know how much money, but it's a box game, right? So you just drive right through buildings. So funny. Oh, and so if you watch Angry Video Game Nerd's like take on this video game, it's so hilarious. He does this thing where he like goes all the way to the edge of the world and he keeps on going and going and going and he gets out of the world. He's like in this black space and also he noticed that you can keep on your accelerator. If you just hold down the accelerator, you can go faster and faster and faster and faster and faster. Really, dude. Yeah, look at that. Look how steep you can drive. Yeah, somebody showed me this on like a stream a while ago, and I typically like will take a link that's funny and or whatever, and save it and watch it later. And I watched it later, and this was the funniest thing ever. Big rigs over the road racing. Yeah, definitely worth checking out. Angry Video Games Nerd. I think this is it right here. Episode 118. Yes. It's a design choice. It could be. That might actually be a possibility. They might have actually designed it on purpose that way. That sounds plausible for some reason. Okay, so this actually simplifies the algorithm quite a lot. I could take out all these X center, Y centers, but I'm gonna do that later when I'm about to check this code in. I want to play with this code a little bit more. And just make it more fun, a little bit more natural. And then what I'll start doing is areas like this, the refill. These are going to need to force the maze generator to have opened up that area. You know what I mean? So in fact, I will do that right now. I should do that in these weird times. If Windows Vista were a game, Oh man, good laughs today. Yeah. All right, so where it chooses to put a refill, that's in the maze. Sets all these refill areas. Where does it do that? Oh yeah, it calls get possible flag locations. There's stores, interests, secrets, world levels. All right, so we're also going to call this said quad open. Yeah. So for this area, so when we're setting an entrance, right? Or the home. Home should be like that too. I think home is up here. But anyways, we'll get to home. But let's do entrance. There we go. Make this shorter, easier to type. Friendlier for me. Not as much work. Okay, so the quadrant we're going for, this first one here, oh, we're in May, so we can do K. Let's say start with southwest quadrant. The direction is going to be east, and guarantee that is open. You know what? I should make a function for this called open center. Make that easier. For area XY. Quad open center XY. All right, then we got X. We can loop over stuff. So quadrant Q equals K southwest. Q is less than or equal to K southeast. Q plus plus. That work? Quadrants, and let's do the DIRs. Think it's north through west. Oh wow. It's just easier to do it the other way. Man. My brain's not working that way right now. Basically, I'm just unrolling the loop for now. So southwest, east, and north. Both true. Northwest, both east and south. Southeast corner, you can go west or north. Northeast corner, you can go west or south. There. Okay, let's put that function where it belongs in this file. All right, there's just convenience method that creates an open center. So now when we're doing the place flags, it's way easier. We could do it at the home quite easily, just like this. This set quad open center, start X, start Y. So that guarantees the home screen. The home screen itself, let's test that out right now. Man, these parts take forever. I feel like it's recompiling everything more often now. But I guess I'm just changing header files. Yeah, a little, I guess, huh? Whoa. So that should have opened up the home screen. It's hard to tell. Let's run around the whole overworld until we find a level entrance that's not quite working. Or, well, not a level entrance, but a I guess I didn't even really need to do that. Because it's using custom patterns. But anyways, the world, the actual settings map will be a nice thing to see like that. Let's see the overworld scene, and now we can reveal that way faster. So, yeah, good. It shouldn't have rebuilt anything there. Okay, so it didn't work. The home screen still has all, it has one of its corners there. There, the home screen is the brighter one in the very bottom middle, and it's yeah, it should have all of its areas open. Oh, maybe I didn't place flags for the overworld scene. No, this calls place flags. Creates a whole world. Yeah. Ah, see, it places the flags before. Here we go. Okay, so we want to generate the maze squared and then place flags because we want to retroactively apply changes to the generated maze squared. We want to make it a little bit more refined and stuff. This is like a third pass, basically. Yes, it worked. It also, did it change other stuff? Oh, it changed the whole world because it uses random numbers. How about this? This is kind of a hack, right? But I'm gonna save the seed. Right, the rand index that we start at when we before I do this second maze squared, and afterwards I'm just gonna restore it. I mean, this is kind of janky, right? Something's telling me that something's wrong about this, but at least it will fix the problem for now. What we're doing here is we're making sure the random numbers are exactly as they just were. This is the trick to creating a procedural game. Okay, so yeah, once again, it's changed. I believe it's changed. So let's put this back. Okay, I'm just trying to remember most of this. So I could just take a screenshot. No, generate maze doesn't require flags. Good question. No, it works entirely off of the existing maze. Doesn't have anything to do with flags. It's just the openings. So yeah, good question though. So yeah, saving the rand index and then restoring it should generate the same world. Right? It's a little different. It is. It's different. Oh, it's different because the oh. It's different because the generate maze squared has a different rand index than it would have before. So I guess I could mimic it. If I really want to do that, I can do that today. But I think what I'll do is change the algorithm eventually. But anyways, I'm gonna set a breakpoint in the maze right here. I'm gonna see what rand index it saves for generating the maze squared. So then I'm just gonna go back and set the rand index manually to that, so it creates the exact same maze. So. Sort of as a comfort, it's like a blanket. Save Randex 354. This rand index 354. 354. Rand index 354. And then go back to the world, change the order again. Should get the exact same thing. Yeah, nice. Okay, cool. Got those distinct features of seeing that closed off H on the right, that little tiny floating I in the middle. And there's two sort of squares, rectangles in the bottom left there. This is the overworld I remember. But now what we have here is that the home screen now has all of its openings set in the middle. And we can go and make sure the home screen has one or the other openings to the top. Close. So set quad open. We want start x, start y, of course. Quadrant is either going to be oh man, it's going to generate an entirely different world anyways. Yeah, I'm just going to have to live with this, I think. Ah, man, it's just bugging me so much because I know that the second I use this get rand, it's going to change this again. And so I'm not going to know what I'm seeing, but at least, I'm just going to, I just have to get used to the fact that this overworld generator is going to change itself a lot. So I just got to let go. Get rand mod 2 equals 0. We're going to either northwest or northeast. We're going to shut off, or we're going to, shut off north. Basically, what needs to happen is this. We need to store R. I guess we could just go rand index minus minus, but not if it's at zero. Damn. Damn. Right? I know. I'm sitting here going. I have let go of the R part. But now I'm just thinking, should I shut off or enforce the opening? I probably should. Enforce the opening of the other, basically. Then we need to do this for the area above it, too. So start Y plus 1. R mod 2 equals 0. This is going to be south. All these are south. There. Let's check that over. We got X, Y, R2. Let's call this flip, actually. Flip. Flip is one. Well, there. So, yeah, either the northwest or the northeast is closed, and then the opposite, either the northeast or the northwest, is forced to be open. And then on the next screen up, it goes either the southwest or the southeast, based on the flip, south, closed off, just like the north on the one below. And the same thing, southeast, southwest, or the opposite. Okay, I think that should work. This is going to be a totally new maze. Cool. All right, there. We've got that world. Let's just change the world seed to get some different ones. Sunbringer read, Sunbringer write. Zero mega seed. Let's set it to wizard. See if we can get a different kind of flop going on there. Whoa, look at that one. Yeah. That one has an opening to the top right. And looks like got two openings there to the left. That's cool. Okay, so yeah, and we can do different kind of openings when we call set or pattern openings, and it has both of them open. Yeah, let's do that now too. And let's set up, so we're gonna run this over, play this over world. So we wanna do, yeah, let's just start playing it first of all. Oh yeah, one thing first, pattern home should determine whether it is flipped based on the maze's not if it has a style rock northeast, but if it has maze get quad or is quad open area pause dot x area pause dot y quadrant k northwest compaster k north there. And so, oh, this is maze. It's kind of getting annoying having to type maze every time for that. This one's just K-Dur North. Also annoying that I keep missing those up. Anyways, flipped. Okay, let's see if that works. So if this does work, what'll happen is, It'll put the opening for this home screen on the right side of the screen, so that the actual cave fits in nicely. Looks like it did, but it had to carve another exit on this screen. So now I'm gonna make it so. Yo, what's up, Silly Billy Bear? It's going great. And Songbringer's coming great. Working on this new maze generator algorithm. Sort of like this. Each one of these little grids is an area of the overworld. And the white lines are the openings from one area to another. And now I'm implementing it all in the world. So I'm looking at the actual overworld. It's generated for that home, that one little highlight I think I highlighted there. So we've got an opening there to the left, two openings to the left, one opening to the right, one opening above. So it's just creating a more interesting overworld this way. Oh, that's kind of interesting. Put that cave like that. Right? It's the old game, the game from a day ago, the old game. All of the levels weren't as interesting as this. That's really interesting. Look how that turned out. I have no idea how that happened. Oh, weird. So weird. So, but I need to work on more random patterns for this, these, for this pattern openings. This is a key to it all right here. This is what this does is it takes those four openings or eight, actually, yeah, eight openings. There's eight openings per screen now, and then turns them into actual tile openings. So it makes sure it carves out paths, like carves out a path through the rocks, carves out through bushes and things like that that would create obstacles that you couldn't get through that area. So we need to make this smarter in the sense that it can do a path through the center of the screen as well. So right now it's doing paths only to the top, bottom. We want to also be able to do a path through the center. So it would be center. We only want to do it when we're at quadrant southwest. And we also have an opening. Northwest. No, same quad. No. Yeah. Northwest quad. Right? So we're checking if this quadrant is southwest. We want to make sure that if it's open to the northwest too, this is a center type. Or if the quadrant is southeast and the maze is quad open northeast. Yeah, and these need to be west. And these need to be east. Oh, and this needs to be dir. So, and direction equals K what? Cater west. All right, yeah. So for southwest going west, and the maze is open northwest going west. It's just D. There, so those should be centers. The center is gonna have a different start X, start Y. Okay, this needs to be a little different because we're actually gonna continue. So if, so we'll get into this, if that, now if, we're open there, center equals true. Otherwise, we continue. So we don't do this direction because we're going to do a centered one, which is more powerful anyway. So for quadrant southeast, and we're going east. Same thing. Thanks, Azimus. Cheers, man. Good night. Okay. There. So it's going to be different now. If center, we're going to do a different type of. Yeah. Got two switches. So if center, we got one switch. Otherwise, we got another switch. All right, and now if we're center, this should still build just fine. I'll run this, just make sure nothing's crashed. Man, I'm getting hungry. Oh, I never noticed in God mode you can throw your hat so fast so far. That's funny. Okay, so yeah, now all we gotta do is make a center. Wait, it should have. Let's look at this level again. Yeah, so there's two openings to the left. Oh man, I'm getting so tired I can barely code. Maze is quad open. Oh man, just keep rewriting this stuff over and over. Probably should drink a coffee, right? Nah, I need food. I gotta get some dinner. So if Q is equal to maze, K north, west. These could be, yeah, for southwest and it's open, or we're northwest and it's open. This is what continues. There. That was tricky, right? All right. Shouldn't matter yet for East. So yeah, we'll just leave it off for now. So what I should see here is a path open to the bottom left and not a path open to the top left. Yes. Awesome. And also, the maze generator should close off some stuff in the current area. We want to go. Northwest or northeast. South. Closed off. Same thing with so for flipped, then we're gonna use K northwest goes east. K northeast would go west. There. That should close off two more sections so that it should fill in all the rocks for the for this. Didn't work. Let's see if it actually worked with the overworld scene. And after this, yeah, I think I'm gonna have to go to I'm gonna get some dinner for sure. There. Okay. That's interesting. It shut off. It did do what it was supposed to. Yeah, it shut off the two areas right there in that quadrant. So it's doing what it's supposed to. Right, cool. So don't know why. Well, let's take one more screenshot of that before I stop so I can reference this later. We go. Okay, I'm gonna turn this off. So yeah, to recap what I've done today and what I'm working on right now, I'm working on this new overworld. It's supposed to be more interesting. So each path, each area has 16 different sub choices of where the maze can go. So the maze just got 4 times more interesting, or 16 times more interesting. No, four, yeah, just 4 times more interesting, basically. Instead of it just having an exit to the left or to the right, now it has two exits to the left or the right, or a third option is that both of them are on. And in that case, you can do different kinds of centering. So what I'm going to work on tonight is working on this algorithm to make it way more fun and natural too. I'm going to work on the, especially the natural part, just trying to get it so it's not quite as, like, for example, at minimum, the openings will be three, right? Three wide. We got three tall right here and three tiles wide right here where the openings are. Same thing here. Three, three, everything's three. So that's going to be really cool to make it so there are some fours and fives and, you know, work with sine waves and stuff like that and play with it until it gets to look way more natural. This is kind of a cool area right here. I like this area where you've got this shop right here. Oh, that kind of broke the shops, but I'll fix those. Yeah, so just working with this new algorithm to make this overworld way more interesting. And also what this will do is once I'm finished with this, I can place secrets and other types of cool stuff and work with different designs. Like I want to have some areas that are like cliffs, some areas are like waterfalls, there's rivers, there's like gonna be so much more interesting stuff. So that's all what I'm working on right now. So that's it for today's stream. Thanks for watching, everybody. Oh yeah, it did have an altar. It's a shop altar. Right, you guys, so yeah, I'll catch you next time. Hope you're having a great day.